This is Reggie. He likes nothing more than watching TV or playing games. What he doesn't realise is the world outside that window is just as interesting as his game. He won't find zombies or enemy troops outside, but there are some amazing things to see, if you know where and how to look. How would you like an adventure of a different kind, Reggie? You won't need those for now. Okay, let's go. This adventure happens here, outdoors, in your local park. So, this might come in handy. OPAL is a program hoping to inspire people like you and your friends to take an interest in the amazing natural world all around you. There are already more than 650,000 people involved, so join the crowd. OPAL stands for Open Air Laboratories, but don't worry, you don't need to be a scientist. Getting interested in open spaces like your park or garden is where it begins. You can learn about what lives there and how it's all doing. With the help of you, your friends, and anyone who's interested, we can get a clear idea of our environment across the whole country. So why not get outside, get active, and learn about the world around you? You can help to preserve and protect it. Who knows? You might even enjoy it. OPAL surveys are for anyone to take part in, whatever their age or wherever they live. There's just as much to discover in a big city as in the countryside. So let's find out more about the surveys. Let's start with climate. Cloud types, wind direction, and condensation trails from aircraft are all ways to find out what's happening up there. Next, there's an air survey you can take part in. There are lots of clues about air quality all around you. Lichens growing on trees and walls are just one sign of how clean the air is. The soil and earthworm survey looks at the many different types of earthworms there are and the different types of soil in which they live. You can also survey water. Do you know how clean or polluted that pond water is? By looking at what lives in there, we can get some clues. Not everyone likes bugs, but they do all kinds of important jobs, like pollinating or recycling dead materials. The Bugs Count survey helps you look for bugs around you. Biodiversity includes all wildlife and the places they live. The Biodiversity survey looks at different types of hedge and shows us how important these are for providing food and shelter for wildlife. So whatever happened to Reggie? Let's find out. Is that you, Reggie? You've got a nice job, I see. It looks like Reggie has really got involved with the natural world. And he is sharing his interest with others too. Good for you, Reggie.